Maligayang araw sa inyo lahat. Okay. Na-delay tayo ng kaunti, ano, kasi may mga inaayos ako din sa aming eskwelahan din sa Batangas. Maligayang araw, Mr. Poblete. Excuse me. Bagong, ano, bagong kain. Maligayang araw, Mr. Poblete. Maligayang araw, Mr. Martinez and Miss Desepeda. Yan, nadami na tayo, walo na. Hopefully, mayroon pang iba. Okay. Ang ating topic ay truth. Yung mga pinadala ko sa inyo na mga paper ay lahat related doon sa traditional approach na pagsagot, pagtugon doon sa GTA problem. Reviewin natin. Reviewin natin ha, yung ating mga pinag-uusapan. Okay. Ganun eh. Meron tayong traditional concept of knowledge. At yung ating traditional concept of knowledge, merong tatlong indicators. One has to be true. In other words, a knowledge claim should be a statement that is true and has to be believed. In other words, the reason why you retain it, why someone retains it in his memory is because he believes it. And it has to be believed on the basis of a rational justification. Ito natin ha. Traditionally, ang sinasabi natin, a knowledge claim is something that is true, meaning to say, is a statement that is true. And it is a statement that you retain in your memory because you believe it. And your belief is not just a matter of desultory belief, it is a matter of belief that is highly justified and rational at that. Ngayon, ang sinasabi nga natin, nagka-problema yan. Bakit? Kasi gawa nga nung binigay ni Gettier. Meron tayong Gettier problem. Ano yun? Pinakita ni Gettier na may counter instance yung generalization na ito. What's the generalization? Given any X, X is knowledge if and only if X is true, X is believed, and X is justified to be believed. Kasi sinasabi ni Gettier, you can show that there would be occasions where a statement may be true, may be believed, and may be justified in believing, but it cannot yet be considered knowledge because on certain occasions, such claim may be accidental. Yan yung ibig sabihin ng GTA problem eh. Merong counter instance. So, our generalization, tagilid, may counter instance eh. May counter example. Okay. Now, to be able to overcome the GTA problem, you can either one, adjust the justification for believing the justification for believing the statement so that it does not become accidental. Yun yung maraming approach. At yung belief, sinasabi natin, should be warranted. Hindi lang siya belief, kung hindi man kung hindi man ordinary belief, should be warranted, should be reliable, for predicting. Now, ito yung problema. Kasi, notice that when you say belief, susundan nyo ga. So, ito yung problema. Notice that when you say belief, that means it is a proposition or a statement or, if you like, even a sentence that you retain in your memory. By definition, that is what a belief is. No matter what you believe, it is whatever it is, as you state it in some proposition or sentence or statement, you keep it in your memory. Precisely because that's what a belief is. Now, why would you keep it in your memory? Because it is true. That's the reason why you retain it in your memory, because it is true. I don't think anyone is going around the university trying to memorize as many falsehoods as possible. You go around the university to find as many propositions or sentences, preferably generalizations, that are true. Anong? Do you go around your life meron ba sa inyo going around skippity hopping to the barber shop looking for, ay, this is something false, I will retain it in my mind. Oh, this is something false, I will retain it in my mind. This is something false, I will retain it in my mind. We go around the university trying to find as many truths as we can, and we retain them in our mind. The truth that today the sun has risen from the east, you retain it in your mind. You're the truth that yesterday the sun has risen from the east, you retain it in your mind. The truth that the other day the sun has risen from the east, you retain it in your mind. So many of them you retain, and precisely because you retain them, you remember them, then you're able to generalize and say, whenever the sun rises, it rises in the east. And therefore, you are able to say, if tomorrow the sun will rise from the east. Yun yung takbo ng usapan eh. Yan. Ngayon, anong ibig sabihin? Very important that what you believe is something true, precisely why you retain it in your memory. Now, when you justify, maraming issues. When you justify, say you have one statement, what happens when you justify? You have one statement, one sentence. Why do you know, presuming you know some sentence that is true, out of it, you derive another sentence that is true. And because you believe that sentence to be true, then you're able to believe another sentence to be true. And this goes on ad infinitum. Now, when we justify, our justification should end somewhere. Hindi pwedeng nakabitid. As you go in this direction, as you go in that direction, we should have some kind of foundation, basis or foundation. Meaning to say, kung Euclidean geometry ang pinag-uusapan, ang foundation ng Euclidean geometry, yung axioms. And you presume them to be unquestionable. And out of these axioms, you derive some other rules. From where you derive some other rules. From where you derive some other rules. You remember, yung Euclidean geometry model. And your axioms serve as your foundation. And yung mga paper, kung binasa ninyo, problematic din ito. So dito, problema na tayo. Bakit? I'll tell you about it later. Dito, problema tayo. Bakit? Kasi inevitably, yung foundation mo needs itself to be true. Eh kung hindi mo makita yung foundation mo, edi paano mo sasabihin yung other derived sentences mo ay true, yung other derived propositions are true. Kaya problemado yung ano eh, yung epistemology world, nung na-discover yung Gödel's theorem of incompleteness. Pag may time kayo, basahin nyo to. Gödel's theorem of incompleteness. Yung Gödel's theorem of incompleteness discovered in the 1930s brings us a question about the nature of justification, not only justification of our propositional knowledge, justification of our mathematical knowledge. Itong Gödel's theorem of incompleteness, meron niyang version ni Alan Turing. Sandali ha. Kung may time kayo, panoodin nyo to. Gödel's incompleteness theorem, ha? Merong maganda ito, magandang ano to, magandang paliwanag to.
The free version checks basic spelling and grammar. Grammarly Premium, on the other hand,
kung may time kayo, ito yung isang pwede niyong panoodin. Discoveries of the 20th century leading to questions, seemingly unanswerable questions involving the nature of justification. Itong isa, Gödel's theorem of incompleteness. Meron pang isa. Turing's halting problem. Well, anyway.
Beginning or your assumptions, and the conclusion is the bit you want to establish, the bit that you reason to with your argument. And we want to know, is there a test that will tell us? Yes.
Đấy hả? Okay. So meron tayong discoveries of the 20th century. Isa yung Gödel's theorem of incompleteness, isa yung Turing's halting problem. I will leave it up to you to discover what these are. Sino si Turing? Si Alan Turing. Si Alan Turing yung naka-discovery noong paano magawa yung universal machine which later came to be known as your computer. Okay, discovery ito ng 20th century. Gödel's theorem of incompleteness, Turing's halting problem. They both question the nature of justification. Babalikan natin yan, but ang gusto lamang nating sabihin ngayon, mukhang lahat ng mga sagot dun sa GTA problem involving justification, belief, and truth, palso. Kaya nga, yung mga paper na pinabasa ko sa inyo, walang katapusan eh. Hindi matapos-tapos. Sinasurvey lang nila yung mga approaches, pero walang satisfactory answer to the GTA problem. Tingnan natin, walang satisfactory answer to the GTA problem. Ngayon, ang sagot natin, kaya walang satisfactory answer to the GTA problem kasi central issue to questions about the nature of justification and beliefs. Balikan natin, the nature of beliefs and justification ay the nature of truth. Now, ano yung nature of truth? 20th century concept of truth or discussions about truth. Dito natin, 20th century discussions about truth. Ay ano? Says one, truth brings with it contradictions as a concept. Truth brings with it contradictions as a concept. Two, truth seems to be trivial. Again, 20th century discussions. Okay. Ito yung ating focus of attention ngayon. Ito. Truth brings with it contradictions, or if you like, paradoxes. And there's a way of looking at truth as something that is trivial. Ganun eh. Why do you retain your beliefs? Because intuitively you believe them to be true. Now, why do you believe them to be true? Because you seem to remember that you have enough justification, sufficient justification for believing them to be true. In other words, merong evidence, nakita mo, or ginamitan mo ng mathematical analysis, and so you know they are true, those statements. And knowing they are true, you believe them, and you retain them in your mind. But what if what if it looks like you do not really understand what truth is all about? Then whatever justification you're talking about, and therefore whatever belief you're talking about, will be held in abeyance. Bitin, held in abeyance. Bakit? Eh, kung malabo sa iyo yung concept ng truth, eh, di, hindi mo pwedeng sabihin because they are true, you retain them. Kung malabo sa iyo yung concept ng truth, eh di pagpapagod mo ng pag-justify that your belief is true, eh useless. Or kung di man useless, tagilid. Yun ang dating. Okay. So ngayon, ganito. Let me call your attention to two authors. One of them is this. This fellow is Alfred Tarski. He wrote a paper in the 1940s. Well, the title of the paper is The Semantic Conception of Truth. Pwede nyo i-download yan from the net. Let me repeat, pwede nyo i-download yan from the net. Bahala na kayo maghanap, ano? The Semantic Conception of Truth. Anong sinasabi ni Alfred Tarski dyan? Actually, medyo mahirap basahin yung paper niya, pero isisimplify ko na lang. Ganito. Supposing you have the sentence, snow is white. Okay. Snow is white. How do you know the sentence, snow is white, is true? How do you know it is true? Meron tayong traditional traditional theories of truth. Ano yung ating traditional theories of truth? How do you know something is true? You use the correspondence theory of truth. Made popular by no other than Aristotle. Anong sabi ng correspondence theory of truth? If what you think corresponds, if what you think corresponds with your experience, then what you think can be described as true. Yun lang ibig sabihin nun. No? Correspondence theory of truth. If what you think corresponds with your experience, then what you think can be said to be true. So, yan. Correspondence theory of truth. Pero turns out, merong experiences will be truly musical for one, but noise for another. We've already been talking about that over and over again. So sabi nila, itong correspondence theory, kulang. Correspondence as a measure, dapat dagdagan natin. Anong idadagdag natin? Dagdagan natin ng another measure. Ano yung measure? Coherence. Ito naman ay ang nagpauso nito ay si Immanuel Kant. Si Immanuel Kant, excuse me, napansin niya, nag-aaway si Isaac Newton at saka si Gottfried Leibniz. And sinasabi ni Isaac Newton, time is independent of human experience. Sabi ni Leibniz, malabo yan. Why? Because you know time, because you have the experience of observing motion, for example, of the arm hands are the hands of the clock or a watch, or the motion of sand falling within an hourglass. So, or the motion of the sun rising from the east and then setting in the west. Without that experience, you will have no concept of time. Doon sa away na yan, sinasabi ni Immanuel Kant, kasi merong past and prior experiences si Newton na kakaiba sa past and prior experiences ni Leibniz. We're talking here of Isaac Newton and Gottfried Leibniz. Magkaiba sila ng concept of time. Now remember, ang problema, ang time, hindi mo na pipisil-pisil, na amoy-amoy, natitikman. So if they have differences in how they view time, how they explain. Ang sinasabi ni Immanuel Kant, what is coherent, ergo therefore the requirement of coherence, what is coherent for Newton may not be coherent for Leibniz. Let me explain it in another way. I wake up in the morning, I have this sentence in my mind. I have had such a happy date last night. So I had a happy date last night. May sentence na yan. It's in my mind. But then I remember, and I've always known, that mahirap ako makipag-date. Bakit? May asawa na ako eh. And I also remember na hindi lang mahirap makipag-date dahil may asawa na ako. Ang tapang nung asawa ko, abogado pa. Ako naloko na. At I remember that yung susi ng kotse nandun sa leg ng asawa ko, nakatali sa kanyang leg, ay hindi ko magagamit ang kotse. Paano ako magde-date? At even if hindi ako magkokotse, hindi rin ako makalabas ng gate. Bakit? Ay yung susi naman ng aming gate ay nandun din sa leg ng aking asawa. Paano ako makakalabas ng bahay? And even if makalabas ako ng bahay, ay alam ko na wala akong baon sapagkat hindi ako binigyan ng baon nung araw kakahapon ng aking asawa. Eh paano ako magde-date? Wala akong baon. At ito pa yung catch. Hindi ako makakaalis ng aking kwarto. Bakit? Meron kaming limang Jack Russell na pagkaiingay. Pagka ako'y umalis ng aking kama, magtataho lang. Magigising ang asawa ko. Naloko na. So, that sentence which I am so happy with, and what is that sentence? Ang sarap-sarap ng date ko kagabi. Hindi pwedeng maging totoo because incoherent with my other beliefs in my mind. Ay, ang dami nila. And so I investigate and I see, well, hindi coherent. Bakit hindi coherent? Ay, lintik na pala na yun. Nalaginip lang ako eh. Akala ko lang eh, kadate ko kagabi si Taylor Swift. Eh, hindi naman pala. Ah, by the way, ayaw ko si Taylor Swift. Kadaming boyfriend doon eh, lintris. Okay, balik tayo sa usapan. So, sabi ni Immanuel Kant, hindi lang that your experience must correspond with what you think, what you think must cohere with other bits of information that you also are thinking about. So, yung tawag dito sa ganitong theory of truth na dapat ay dalawa ang batayan ng truth, one is correspondence, one is coherence, ang tawag dyan, very obviously, coherence theory of truth. So, yung coherence theory of truth. Pero naman, nag-complain, sabi nila, yung coherence theory of truth na yung kalokohan yan. Bakit? Kasi ganito. So, may nagsabi, yung coherence theory of truth na yan, hindi pwede. Bakit sinabing ganyan? Ano? Ganito. Sabi nila, precisely, doon nga tayo nagkakaproblema. What is coherent for one is incoherent for another. And so, hindi mo malalaman sinong tama at sinong mali. Sabi nila, instead of coherence, ang dapat gagawin natin, ang ating requirement ay ano? Ito. ang ating requirement ay instead of coherence, sorry ha, ay ano, usefulness. Yan. May mga nagsabi, hindi lang sa what you think must correspond with what you experience, what you think must be useful. And between two ways of looking at the world, what is musical is noise for another, you simply ask which is more useful. And this is called the pragmatic theory of truth. Ang mga scientists, ganyan. Pragmatic theory of truth. So, tatlo yung classic theories of truth. Isa yung correspondence theory of truth, isa yung coherence theory of truth, and now yung pragmatic theory of truth. Now, whether you have correspondence or coherence theory of truth or pragmatic theory of truth, we have a problem. Why? Because precisely, they are theories. Parang ganito. These are traditional truths about truth. You see, in principle, we should be talking about truths about truth. We cannot talk about theories. Remember, what is a theory? A theory is a term used in science. What is a theory? A theory is a generalization. A generalization is a sentence that is an expression of a pattern. Now, what's the point? As practiced in science, a theory is expected to be revised or rejected as time goes by. So, what does that mean? A theory cannot be described as true. Theories are not true. Theories are never true because truth cannot be revised or rejected. Theories precisely are expected to be revised or rejected. So, what we have here are not truths about truth. They're only theories about truth. Hindi ba paradoxical yan? You need to know about truth and you can only have theories about truth. Let me repeat. You need to know about truth. But then you have to have only theories about truth. They are not truths about truth. If they are not truths about truth, so does that theory, whatever it is, strengthen your truth, your concept of truth? Diba? Paradoxical, ano? See, we're talking about theories of truth, so we strengthen our concept of truth. We consolidate our concept of truth. But then in the process, as we consolidate, we can only come up with theories that are never true. Well, ako na. So, balik tayo dun sa sentence, snow is white. Snow is white is true. Okay, when you say snow is white is true, okay, when you say snow is white is true, you have a sentence that is about snow. Tanggalin muna natin yung snow is white as yung is true. Let's just focus on snow is white. Tanggalin muna natin to. Let's just focus on snow is white. Snow is white is a sentence about an object. About an object. Okay. That's your object sentence. That's your object sentence. Now notice that on the other hand, you have another sentence. And what is that sentence? Snow is white is true. So let me repeat. There are two sentences. Snow is white. That's sentence number one. And there's another sentence. There's another sentence. Snow is white is true. So, dalawang sentences. Now, notice, this sentence is about an object. Unfortunately, that object melts, but still an object. But this sentence is about a sentence. Magkaiba yan. So, we call this sentence the object sentence. And we call this object the meta sentence. Ang tawag natin dito, meta sentence. Bakit meta sentence? Meta in Greek means over or above. Because it is a sentence about a sentence. Okay. Notice it is also possible to say that what? Snow is white is true is true. Dito natin. It is also possible to say snow is white is true is true. You're actually saying this sentence here is true. So what you now have is a meta-meta sentence. And you can have a meta-meta-meta-meta sentence. Okay. Now, focus on the word true. And the expression is true. Is true. Focus on the word true. And the word is true. And the expression is true. The phrase is true. Okay. Notice that is true is a description of the property of a sentence. A description of some property or dimension of a sentence. When you say is true, you're giving a description of some property or dimension of a sentence. The same with the expression is false. Okay. Which goes to show truth as we use the term true, truth appears to be, therefore, a dimension of a sentence. That is what truth is all about. Truth is some dimension of some sentence. Okay. So, what are we saying? Conclusion. Truth, let me repeat, conclusion, truth is a dimension of a sentence. When you say a sentence is true or a sentence is false, you're describing truth about the sentence, some dimension of a sentence. If that is the case, then we have a problem. We have to conclude, therefore, truth is conventional. Why? And this is where the paradox is. We already discussed this. I'll just repeat it again. Truth is conventional. Why? Because truth is a dimension of some sentence. When you say a table is long, or a table is short, or a table is high, or a table is low, or a table is wide, or a table is narrow, you're describing some dimension of the table. Similarly, when you say a sentence is true or a sentence is false, you're describing some dimension of the sentence. But then, sentences are products of culture. The way languages are products of culture, therefore conventional. All languages, even the language of science, are products of culture. In the case of mathematics, for example, it is the culture of science that produces mathematics. Sentences are products of culture, and since truth is a dimension of some sentence, therefore truth is conventional. Paradoxical yan. Paano nangyari yun? We have here some kind of a contradiction. Okay? We have here what is called an oxymoron. Truth brings with it paradoxes. This is one of them. Let me give you another. Okay? Let me give you another. Snow is white. That's your object sentence. Okay? Snow is white. Your sentence you're describing as true. It's true. Okay? So you have the wider sentence. But then as you say, snow is white is true, you can actually say, snow is white is true. Sorry lang po. Snow is white is true if and only if indeed snow is white. If and only if, by experience, snow is white. Yan. Okay. So, gamitan natin ang symbolic analysis. Snow is white is true. You say, okay, S for snow is white. Okay. So, we say, S, sorry, Mali. S for snow is white. Okay, symbolize natin na S for snow is white. So, S in quotation mark is true. If and only if by experience, if and only if by experience, no, it's white. Now, you will notice here, this is also snow is white. So we will have to write S in quotation mark is true if and only if by experience S, which is now your new sentence. Okay, now let us try to summarize this or symbolize this. Okay, let's try to symbolize this. Say, is true if and only if S. Okay, so you have this now expression. S in quotation mark, IFFS, which is our expression of this in symbolic form. But then, what if you come up with a language? What if you come up with a language for your computer program? New computer program language. Unfortunately, do sa computer programming languages, walang expression such as if and only if na ganito. So, ang gagawin natin, sasabihin na lang natin, okay, S is true, S in quotation mark, and S. In fact, sa mathematical logic, hindi tayo gumagamit ng ampersand. Sa mathematical logic, itong ginagamit natin. Sandali ha. Sa mathematical logic, ang ginagamit natin ito. S and S. Yeah. So focus your attention here. What have we done? We have simplified our expression here. Snow is white. Is true if and only if indeed snow is white into this. Now, what's the effect? Notice that I do not use the word true. There is no word true that I am using when I express the same thing. Meaning to say, if I want to say snow is white, it's true. Snow is white is true. If I want to say this, I'll just write. Okay, let me repeat. If I want to say this, I can actually just write. S in quotation mark and not S. If I want to say snow is white, it's false. I can actually only say I can only say, or I can express the same thing by saying only that is and not is. So, I have a new language. Where true and false as concepts are absent. In other words, in my new language, if I want to say some sentence is true, I'll just write this. In my new language, if I want to say some sentence is false, I'll just write this. So what does this mean? Conclusion, truth is trivial. Truth is trivial. Why trivial? Because you can come up with a language without it. You can actually program an artificial intelligence that is more intelligent than you, and he does not know what the term true and what the term false is all about. Yan. You can come up with artificial intelligence with a computer language that is so intelligent, so much more intelligent than us, and yet that artificial intelligence need not have to have the term true and the term false, and therefore the term truth in his language or in its language. Yan. So truth is conventional, truth is trivial. Implication siya ng paper ni Alfred Tarski. Hindi pa natapos. Meron pa tayong isang pag-uusapan. Sino? Si Peter Unger. Yan, oh. Peter Unger, born in April 25, 1942, apparently still alive, is a contemporary American philosopher and professor in the Department of Philosophy at New York University. His main interests in the fields of mathematics, epistemology, ethics, and philosophy of mind. Now, let me tell you about what Peter Unger is talking about. Okay, supposing you have a table. Okay, say you have a table. And on your table are many things in it, on it. Okay, so what? Okay, table. And that table is in a room. Supposing you have a room. Okay, that table is in a room. Okay. And in the room. Okay, sabihin natin, in the room. Okay, sabihin natin na. There are many things in it. So what's the point? Okay, so listen. I can say something about the table. Say, I have a pen on the table. Very good. I have a teacup, teeny weeny teacup on the table. Very good. Teacup. And then I'll say, I have a mouse on that table. In other words, I can say so many things about the table. And more in particular, I can say so many things true about the table. Okay. In principle, and we can do this if we like, but it will be very difficult. In principle, we can list down all the sentences that can be said that are true about the table. So we have all the sentences that can be said true about the table. Now, for purposes of convenience, let's just say the set of all sentences that are true about the table, we'll call this the whole truth about the table. Okay. So there is the whole truth about the table. Okay. Notice that part of the whole truth about the table is that it is in a room. Okay. One truth about the room, there is a table in it. That's one. One truth about the room, there is a door that leads outside the room. Okay. One truth about the room, there is a ceiling fan in the room. There are so many things I can say about the room that are true. In principle, I can list down all the true sentences I can say of the room. And one of them is this true sentence, there is a table in the room. Okay. Let us, for convenience, call all the sentences that are true about the room, the whole truth about the room. Okay. Notice that part of the whole truth about the room is the truth about the table. Conversely, part of the whole truth about the table is the whole truth about the room. Let me repeat. Part of the whole truth about the room is the whole truth about the table. Part of the whole truth about the table is the whole truth about the room. In fact, part of the whole truth about the room is the whole truth about Quezon City, or the whole truth about National Capital Region, or the whole truth about, because you see, part of the whole truth about the National Capital Region is the whole truth about Luneta. And by the way, part of the whole truth about Luneta is the whole truth about Jose Rizal over yonder in the monument. So in a manner of speaking, part of the whole truth about the table is the whole truth about Jose Rizal. Part of the whole truth about the table is the whole truth about the serisal. Oh, philosopher talaga, ano? Yan si Peter Unger. And part of the whole truth about the serisal in Luneta is the whole truth about the table. In fact, part of the whole truth about the serisal and the whole truth about the table is the whole truth about the earth. And the whole truth about our solar system and the whole truth about the universe. In a manner of speaking, there is only one whole truth. And let's call it the whole truth. Or the whole truth about everything. Okay. So, what is Peter Unger talking about? Sabi ni Peter Unger, so far as our languages are concerned, what are we talking about? Paper by Peter Unger. What's the paper of Peter Unger entitled? It's called Truth. Okay, yung paper ni Peter Unger called Truth ay makikita sa... Okay. Makikita din eh sa libro na Are. May libro, may copy ako ng libro na Are. Hanapin ko pa. Nandito sa libro na to, ano? Now, sinasabi ni Peter Unger, so far as natural languages are concerned, like English, we cannot deny that there is an assumption of the existence of some whole truth about everything. There is this assumption. There is this assumption of the whole truth about everything. Given our usage of the term truth, it will be noticed that there is the assumption or presumption of the existence of the whole truth about everything. Now, next question. Has anyone seen the whole truth about anything, everything? Malabo. Lumabas lang ng Earth, ang hirap na. Lalabas ka pa ng solar system. Lalabas ka pa ng galaxy natin. Naloko na. So, yan, Miss Javier. Hoy, maligayang araw, Miss Javier.
Hello po.
Nasusundan ba kayo sa mga pinagdadadaldal ko?
Medyo po.
Mamaya sira na rin ang ulo mo. balik tayo dito. Ang sinasabi ni Peter Unger, lahat ng natural languages may assumption that there is the whole truth about everything. When, by virtue of how we use the term truth, the whole truth about the table, the whole truth about the room, the whole truth about national capital region, the whole truth or the concept of truth, as we use the term truth, indicates some assumption of some whole truth about everything. And the whole truth about everything is composed of truths that are all related to one another in some system. Now, question, has anybody seen the whole truth about everything? Of course, malabong sabihin yan. Because in the first place, nobody lives forever. And even if you are alive right now, we cannot talk about the truth about the past as if they are really truth that we know wholly. So, sabi ni Peter Unger, this assumption of the whole truth about everything is metaphysical. This assumption about the whole truth about everything is metaphysical. Let me talk about the word meta. I already told you about meta earlier. Meta, as an expression, means over and above in Greek. Meta, Meta as an expression means over and above something. Ganito, yung expression metaphysical, inimbento ng mga Greeks kasi yung mga Greeks were very fond of speculative thought. Let me repeat that. Mga Greeks are very fond of speculative thought. Bakit speculative thought? Halimbawa, sabi ng isang Greek, there is only one whole truth about everything. Okay, pinag-usapan lang natin. But then, how do you know that? It is as if lumabas ka ng ating nature, and so you're over and above nature, and you can see nature. And as you can see nature, or you can see the universe, or you can see everything connected to one another. And that's why you can say, speculatively, that there is only one whole truth about everything. Parang lumabas ka ng everything, lumabas ka na. But that cannot happen, you can only speculate. Yan. Or, pwede nating sabihin, there is a claim that everything in the universe is coherent. Everything in the universe is coherent, run by coherent rules. Rules that are therefore never contradictory with one another. How do you know that? Eh, kasi lumabas ka ng universe at tinignan mo, ay ito, nakikita ko sa universe, parang ganun. In other words, you have that expression, metaphysical, in a manner of speaking, to say that what you're dealing with is something speculative. Because nobody ever leaves the earth. Nobody ever leaves the universe. Nobody ever gets out of the universe so that you can look into the universe. No such thing as outside looking in when you're dealing with the universe. So, anong gustong sabihin ni Peter Unger? Very simple. Our concept of truth is metaphysical and therefore speculative. Yan. Our concept of truth is metaphysical and therefore speculative. So, we end up with saying what? Ito, Ms. Javier, yung katse. We end up with saying, on one hand, truth is conventional. On the other hand, truth is trivial. And now, in addition, we're also saying truth is metaphysical. Parang ang labo naman ng mundo natin. So, sinasabi natin, ulitin natin, truth is confusing as a concept. Truth is confusing as a concept. Why? Because truth is conventional, which is very difficult to swallow. And truth is trivial. And again, very difficult to swallow given our training and our culture. And now we're saying truth is metaphysical and therefore speculative. Therefore, speculative in nature. Okay. So these are issues about truth that bug philosophers. If you're not clear about truth, if truth is unclear, that leads us to conclude the nature of beliefs unclear. The nature of beliefs unclear. That will lead us to say, therefore, the nature of justification unclear. Naloko na. Nagkaleche-leche na tayo. The nature of justification unclear. If we cannot be clear about truth, we cannot be clear about beliefs. We cannot be clear about justification. Ang labo. And ang sinasabi ko ngayon bilang teacher ninyo, kaya yung mga paper na ipinadala ko sa inyo, ano, paper about justification, paper about beliefs, paper about science, ay nagkakagulo ang usapan. Walang consensus. Lalo na sa nature of justification. Sa nature of justification, walang consensus. What I'm saying right now is this. We may have to reinvent epistemology. See, traditional epistemology, traditional epistemology centers on what? Traditional epistemology centers on the nature of or focuses on the nature of truth, beliefs, and justification. But since traditional concept of belief involves truth, nature of truth, and traditional concept of justification involves nature of truth, okay. If this is the case, what's the case? Traditional concept of belief involves nature of truth. Traditional concept of justification involves nature of truth. This leads us to say, given our confusion regarding the nature of truth, we may have to reinvent. We may have to reinvent our concept of epistemology. That's what I'm saying. Now, if we have to reinvent our concept of epistemology, can we do that? Well, Ms. Javier, one, we have already shown how we can reinvent our concept of mind. Salamat kay Gilbert Ryle, which of course, who of course is one of our inspirations sa linguistic analytic philosophy. Now, earlier than Gilbert Ryle in the 19th century, we have already come to reinvent mathematics. Kung nag-aral kayo sa akin ng logic or nag-aral kayo sa akin ng Philo 1, alam niyo gusto kong sabihin. In the 19th century, George Boole has come to challenge the traditional concept of mathematics and in the process have redefined mathematics and therefore reinvented mathematics. But in the process also, George Boole has come to not only redefine mathematics, he has come to reinvent Aristotelian logic, and ergo now we have mathematical logic. We can do that. We can reinvent mathematics, we can reinvent logic. Now we have been reinventing the concept of mind. We can also reinvent the concept of epistemology. Ito ngayon, Ms. Javier, ang tanong, kung nandiyan ka pa, ha? Ang tanong, nai-imagine mo baga kung paano natin marireinvent ang mundo ng epistemology without the concept of truth?
Honestly, sir, it's hard to imagine.
Parang ang labo, di ba? Nakakasira ng ulo.
Opo. Opo, sobra.
Pero hindi natin ma-deny that truth is somehow conventional. Hindi natin ma-deny that truth is trivial. We can use mathematical logic to prove that. In fact, we already have artificial intelligence in the form of GPT-3 and maybe even more sophisticated forms. And guess what? Their language do not have to have the expression of true and false. And as we can see, Peter Unger very, very easily can show to us that our languages seem to imply that truth is a metaphysical concept, the whole truth about everything. So, ang labo. Either we retain traditional epistemology, which is so confusing, or we reinvent it so that epistemology can help us predict our future, so we can have control over our destiny, independent of the gods and the deities, dependent on our capacity to reason. Yun ang bottom line natin eh. And so, yan ang pag-uusapan natin next meetings. How do we reinvent our concept of epistemology without having to rely so much on the concept of truth? We will not discard it. We will set it aside and experiment, see where we can go, see where we can invent a new world, a world of epistemology without the whole truth about everything, without the concept of truth as we have now seen that is problematic. Yan. Sige nga, isulat natin din, ha? So, there.
So, hindi po kayo naka-share screen.
Ah, hindi ako naka-share screen. Hindi, di nila ang sa chat. We have to reinvent epistemology. Epistemology. Pag ini-reinvent natin, how? Without the concept of truth. Yan ang pag-uusapan natin next meetings. Kaya bitin yung aking binigay sa inyo na syllabus. Kasi hindi ko alam kung masusundan yung usapan natin. So now I have another question. Ms. Javier, kahit paano naman nasundan mo yung ating usapan?
Opo, nakasundan yun po.
Kasi kung naintindihan, kung nasusundan yung ating usapan, nakikita niyo yung problema, we have a what you might call a wicked problem. Because you see, as we reinvent epistemology, that also means we reinvent our concept of knowledge altogether. That means we reinvent a whole new world. We are not just reinventing some term, we are reinventing a whole new world. If we are successful with it, then hopefully that means we can predict better. See, that's the bottom line, to predict better so we have more control over our destiny, our future. Okay, before anything else, let me remind you, ganito. Kung tinignan yung syllabus natin, ang syllabus natin hanggang meeting tayo ng, anong tawag dito? 16 days. Pag umabot na tayo ng 15th meeting, nakailan na tayo? 12, ano? Pag umabot na tayo ng meeting number 15, ay that means yung susunod, meeting number 16, ay tayo ay tayo ay magkakaroon na ng examen. So ngayon pa lang, bunuin ninyo, unfortunately, talaga naman umiski ako, binubuno ko yung mga yan, bunuin nyo yung mga readings. Next meeting, ang gagawin natin, garne. Hindi tayo gagamit ng StreamYard na ginagamit ko ngayon. Ang gagamitin natin, Google Meet. Sa Google Meet, ibig sabihin, lahat kayo present. Lahat tayo pwede mag-usap-usapan, mag-debate. Kulang na lang magsuntukan. So, sa Google Meet natin next meeting, orally, magkukwentuhan tayo. And you're supposed to ask me questions about yung mga binasa nyo. Parang halimbawa, nabasa mo, Miss Javier, po tayo na naman na rin, The Sciences and Epistemology, hindi ko maintindihan eh. O kaya aring theories of justification, hindi ko maintindihan eh. Or aring, ano nga ba yung huli kong binigay sa inyo? Virtue epistemology, ano? Tama, gamit sa Javier, ano? Virtue Opa. Epistemology. Yung Opa. Mga yan na binigay kong readings, pag-uusapan natin lahat-lahat sabay-sabay. Although, binigyan ko na kayo ng preview, yung lahat ng mga yan, ang mga sinabi natin, virtue epistemology, theories about justification, at kung ano-ano, ay lumalabas, ay lalo lang nagugulo ang mundo natin. Ay sabi nga natin, which means probably we have to look for why gumugulo ang mundo natin. And yan nga ang sabi natin. Kaya gumugulo ang mundo natin, gawa nga ng concept of truth eh, hindi siya malinaw. We presume malinaw yung concept of truth, pero hindi naman. And as I've already shown you now, we may have to reinvent epistemology and live in a world without truth. Pwede kaya yun? Pagka kayo journalism student, napakahirap niyan. Lalo na ngayon, Ms. Javier, panahon ng fake news. Can you live in a world without truth where you have fake news everywhere? What does that mean?
Oh my gosh.
Oh no. Joseph.
Opo,
okay. Ms. Javier, anong course mo?
Philo po.
Oh, philosophy. Pagka ikaw ay naging lawyer, you will be dealing with the notion of truth. Sa law.
Opo.
Theories, legal theory, maraming kinalaman sa notion of truth and how and evidences. Parang malabo yata na may mundo ka ng judiciary na walang concept of truth.
Opo.
So, pag-uusapan natin next meeting. Maligayang araw po. Pasensya na. At napadaldal ako masyado. Hindi pa pala naman. Akala ko overtime na tayo. Sige, ganito. Maligayang araw po. Pag-isipan ha. Next meeting, pag-aralan niyo yung mga readings natin para may maitatanong kayo.
May question po ako.
Sige. Oo.
If 12th meeting po ngayon, so, bale
well,
po.
Sorry, ganito. Estimate ko lang 12th meeting. Estimate ko 12th meeting. Yan. Oo. Therefore, what?
Sige po. So, ang exam po after reading break na po, kailan gawin reading break natin?
Kailan?
April 4 to 15 po, kasi 2 weeks.
Ay, naku, may reading break pala nga tayo, ano?
Opo. So, pwede mga naman April 18 po, pa po.
Ay, ganito na lang. Ibibigay ko yung examen bago mag-reading break. Tapos, isasubmit yung sagot after the reading break, pwede gayon?
Sige po.
Hindi, kung ayaw mo si Javier, ni Javier, edi wag na lang.
Sir, I can't speak for the whole class naman po.
pero, anong preference kaya palagay mo? Siyempre, preference siguro ay bibigay ko before the reading break and then sasubmit ninyo after the reading break. Ano?
Opo, yun po yung personal preference.
Oh, kasi unang-una mabigat yung ating problema eh. How do you reinvent epistemology without truth?
Opo.
Baka natapos na taon, hindi nyo pa nasasagot.
Opo.
So, ganun na lang. I'll give the exam before the reading break and you submit the answers to the exam after the reading break. Ganun.
Sige po.
Okay, daming salamat. Ingat lagi.
Thank you po.
Salamat, Miss Abel. Samahan mo ulit ako next meeting ha. Kalungkot pag mag-isa lang ako din eh.
Ah, sige po. Di ko po kasi nakuha yung link sa email. Kaya di po ako nakakasama. Na-copy-paste ko lang sa YouTube.
Okay. Ingat lagi. Bye-bye.
Bye sige po. Po.